and welcome to Prime News. Now look at the headlines. Final decision on MOI by October end. Continuous meetings in last week of October. Government grants 15 days for public suggestions on MOI policy. One-time settlement of 5 lakh rupees for Tilari Dam affected people. 1,100 farmers to benefit. Closure time fixed to 1.5 months. No hopes of mining resumption till February 2014. Decision only after NIRI report. Government sources say NIRI needs 3 months to complete study. Lalu jailed for 5 years, fined 25 lakhs in fraudulent scam, loses MP seat. CBI special court gives verdict. Former CM Jagannath Mishra faces 4-year jail. And High Court orders status quo in Goa Marketing Federation Board's case, issues notice to Goa government. And now the news in detail. Government will take final decision on medium of instruction by the end of October. The first meeting of MOI's advisory committee was held at Pori on Thursday under the chairmanship of CM Manohar Parikar. Continuous meetings are scheduled from 21st to 24th October to discuss and decide the policy. Government has invited suggestions from public within next 15 days on MOI policy.
The Advisory Committee on Medium of Instruction met for the first time on Thursday at Porvori under the leadership of Chief Minister Manohar Parikar. Education Director Anil Pawar, Education Secretary D.P. Divedi and other members of the committee participated in the meet. These are the few important decisions in the meeting. Final decision on MOI issue by end of October. Continuous meetings from October 21st. Meetings to continue further if needed. Government open for suggestions from public for next 15 days. Suggestions to be submitted to Education Department. Education Department to prepare report by 21st October. BBSM's counsel advocate Uday Bhemre and Savio Lopez of FOS participated in the meet on Thursday. Now all eyes are set on the suggestions and government's final decision on MOI. Laukik Shilkar for Prudent.
One-time settlement of 5 lakh rupees has been finalized for Tilari Dam affected people. The decision was taken at the Standing Committee's meeting on Tilari Dam affected people held at Mumbai. 1,100 farmers will benefit from this financial assistance. The closure time of Tilari Dam has been fixed to 1.5 months.
जे 3 लाख रुपये एज पर स्टँडिंग कमिटी आहे आणि तत्वाचा ते का आम्ही मान्यता दिली आता वैल जो 3-5 पूजे हा पण ते तुम्ही शरद पवार आणि मनोहर पर्रिकर यांच्या बद्दल हे करून ते फायनलाइज करपाचे पण ते डिसिजन हे करचे म्हणून झाले.
The money will be granted to persons whose name has been recommended for government job by each family. After accepting this money, family will not be able to claim any government job.
Total 5 lakh rupiah, one-time settlement. माझे त्यांचे जॉबाचेर कोणतोय अधिकार राहतो ना. त्या फॅमिलीन जाका नॉमिनेट केला जॉब दिवसात जाय म्हणून त्याका ते मेळतले आणि सबमर्शन मध्ये जे लोक असतात त्यांनाच मिळतले ते.
The meeting has also given permission to lay water pipeline for domestic use from Tilari to Asnada. The meeting has unanimously decided to close Tilari Dam from 15th October to 30th November every year for maintenance.
15 October to end of November closure time of Solomon. कॅनल प्रॉब्लेम जाता मधी मधी कॅनल तुटता फुटता किती जाता उदक लिकेज जाता त्यांना आणि तिलारी टू असनोळा बेसिनान पाईपलाईन अप टू तिलारी टू हे आमका हे करचे म्हणून परमिशन दिवचे म्हणून अध्यक्षांनी सांगले जर तुम्ही तुमका तुम्ही तुमच्या खर्चान करता जाल्यार तुमची त्याका आम्ही मान्यता दिता म्हणून.
सिनियर रिपोर्टर लौकिक शिलकार फॉर प्रुडंट.
There are no hopes of mining operations getting resumed till February. The Supreme Court is in no mood to lift the ban till NIRI submits its report. Goa government sources say NIRI will require around 3 months to complete their study. NIRI is expected to start its work in November.
The Council of Sargaonkar, Chogule and Fomento argued in Goa mining case in the Supreme Court on Thursday. They stressed on three aspects: history of mining business in Goa, geographical condition of the state and economic importance of the business. However, Supreme Court clearly stated that buffer zone limit cannot come down below 1 kilometer. Next hearing is scheduled on 22nd October. The hearing will be held continuously on 22nd, 23rd and 24th of October. The hearing will focus on MOEF's report on buffer zone for Goa and Expert Appraisal Committee's lease-wise report of mines in Goa. Goa government has submitted its mining policy before the Supreme Court. The government in its policy has recommended capping of 20 million tons of ore extraction per year. Government has also stated that Goa government will involve NIRI to calculate the ore carrying capacity of Goa. NIRI will take over the work by November. NIRI will take at least 3 months to complete its study. The report is expected by end of January. The matter will then come up before the Supreme Court. This indicates that mining operations will not resume in the state at least till February. The Supreme Court will hear the matter only after NIRI's report. Court will focus on four aspects: NIRI's report, buffer zone, EAC's report and appointment of a regulator. Most importantly, Lok Sabha elections are expected in January 2014. The new government at the centre is expected to take charge by February. The decision on Goa mining case might come during the tenure of next union government. Bureau report, Prudent.
High Court has issued notice to Goa government in the matter of Goa Cooperative Marketing and Supply Federation's board dissolution case. The High Court has also ordered to maintain a status quo till next order.
The High Court of Bombay on Thursday issued notice to Goa government for dissolving board of directors of the Goa Cooperative Marketing and Supply Federation. Four directors of Marketing Federation have filed petitions before the High Court challenging dismissal of board of directors. The court has directed government to file their reply on 14th October and has ordered to maintain status quo till further order. After dissolving board of directors, a three-member panel of administrators have been appointed to run Goa Cooperative Marketing and Supply Federation. The federation at present runs 10 Sarkar Bhandar outlets in the state. Reporter Mukesh Kumar for Prudent.
It's time for a short break. Stay tuned.